So Sam Watson, how was the flight into Toronto on Floyd's jet?
We flew in on that big private jet, man, and it was fun, man. It's nothing like it. Steven out the nose of me.
What's it like to be on a jet? Like, how? Where do you sit? Do you sleep?
I always sit facing, like, you know, I don't sit backwards. Face straight.
More tickets, guys? How was Floyd? Good mood?
Yeah, great mood.
After that press conference,
yeah, it was a great day. It was a great day. When they worked together, they were great. Greg could do this thing too now.
Dana White did this thing. I saw you in the face-off. You went in there to make sure nothing goes crazy.
Yeah, Dana White did this thing too. It was nice.
Sam, what were they telling each other when you were standing right there?
I'm going to get you. I'm going to get you. I'm going to whoop your ass. And you're going to whoop mine. You can't whoop me and all that old crazy shit. They were just talking crazy, man.
Did they serve food on a private jet?
Yeah.
Drinks?
Yeah, the best food ever. Best drinks ever.
Steak, caviar, champagne.
When was the last time you were on a private jet? Like
with
that?
Floyd, only with Floyd.
And how was that experience?
It's always fun. Real nice. 12, 13 people at the most.
Okay,
good. And fantastic, man.
We talked about Mayweather McGregor 2 years ago, a year ago. Now it's happening. It's here. It's real. Break it down, Sam Watson.
Well, it took a long time to get going, but Floyd, it was Floyd's dream to fight this guy. This guy was messing with, talking smack to Floyd, and Floyd didn't like it, and Floyd finally said, okay, let's do it. Floyd went hard at it. He went hard. He knew what he wanted to do. He wanted to. Floyd thinks real big, and he thought real big on this one about the whole wide world see McGregor and Mayweather. He wanted.
You gonna knock him out?
It's gonna be a great fight. He's gonna beat him up for a little while, but McGregor be swinging hard too now. He ain't no chump. I wouldn't put it past him. He ain't no chump to me.
I think his biggest weapon is his mouth, but.
But he got a left hand still. He can hit. I've seen him knock people out. And Floyd's working every day in the gym, getting ready for this. He's not downplaying it for real. Floyd's serious.
Sam, tell me about Philip Greco. What can you tell us about him?
Philip Greco is my main man.
Why?
Because he came to us and he fought Earl Spence on, like, the weight wasn't right.
One day notice.
Yeah, 2 days. I think like 1-2 days. But his weight wasn't right, but he made it right enough to get that fight in. And he just showed me a lot of heart. When he fought Sean Porter, he shouldn't have fought. A lot of things he did, he didn't. But when he got with us now, and it's going to be better. It can't be nothing but better.
Sam. I call him Uncle Sam.
Yeah.
What this guy did for me changed my life.
When he fought Earl Spence, when nobody wanted to see Earl Spence, Phil said, I'll do it, let's go.
How long?
One day and a half.
How many pounds did I lose?
They lose all the way.
60 pounds? Yeah. So, now we're going to bring Toronto. Niagara Falls is going to be the next Vegas, the Vegas of the North.
He's got them kind of dreams like Mayweather. He knows what he wants to do. It just takes a little time. Now he knows what he wants to do. Sold out last time he fought here. That
Niagara
was great.
Falls,
all this Canada, Niagara Falls stuff, he knows it. He's been knowing it all the time.
When we signed, first thing I said,
we got to fight over here.
How do you feel about Canadian fans?
I love them all. I mean,
more people see me?
Oh, yeah. He's going to be the face of this whole thing. No,
let's make it happen, Sam.
He said we're going to do it. You just
got to make it happen, guys. We're going to make it happen.
There you have it. Philip Greco, Sam Watson. Here's the report.com. Melissa Black reporting.